menu reader. Off. Press left trigger to toggle.
How's it going, stream? How is everybody? It's been a while. I don't think I've streamed since I don't know that I've streamed since I've moved my setup around, so let's see.
Should be off.
So this is my first time playing Hogwarts Legacy.
This is my first experience with it. So I don't know what settings to do any of that. So
we shall see. Excuse me.
Is there subtitles anyway?
I shouldn't show this on stream, but I don't care. So when I did the Harry Potter fan club quiz, my house was Ravenclaw, my Patronus was a Basset Hound. So let's see. Pleased to inform you that you have been accepted to at Hogwarts School Witchcraft and Wizardry as a fifth year student. Term begins on September 1st. Preliminary supplies have been collected for you and will accompany you on your journey to the castle. As you may be aware, the decree for the reasonable restriction of underage sorcery prohibits the use of magic by those under the age of 17 outside the school. However, due to your unique circumstances, the ministry has graciously agreed to allow Professor Eleazar Fig, to help you hone your spell casting before escorting you from London to the castle for the start of the return feast and the sorting ceremony. Yours sincerely, Professor Weasley.
deputy headmistress. Not a PG stream, for the record. I guess I'll go with the Harry glasses. Style choices kind of stink. Oh, there's more here. Okay. So I have like a side part. I don't know, what is that? I guess that's good. That's a good color.
A few cobwebs and some dust. Nothing to be concerned.
That was quite something.
Okay, well, I want to be a
I am indeed a student, but I could very well be able to help you. It was wonderful. I believe I'm really going to. That was quite something. A few cobwebs and some dust. Nothing.
We'll go with my real name.
To be concerned about.
I'm surprised I can't make myself better. Here we go. So I don't know if I finished it, but in real life, in the quiz, I was rating cool. Yeah, I did say
it. It appears we are almost ready to depart. It's a pity we didn't have a bit more time to spend on spell casting. I presume you've been practicing the spells we worked on.
I have, Professor.
Well, I'm quite sure I've never seen anyone take so quickly to a secondhand wand. You'll be a force to be reckoned with when you get your own.
Thank you, Professor Fig. I appreciate you working with me before the term begins.
Oh! Eleazar! George! Glad my rather cryptic description of our location did not thwart your finding us.
I've apparated to more vaguely defined destinations than this. Though I confess I may have miscalculated slightly on my first try. Gave quite the fright to some theatergoers in the West End.
It's been much too long. When I received your owl, I must say I...
Best not speak here, Eleazar.
Of course. Why don't we speak en route to Hogwarts? We have a start of term feast and a sorting ceremony to get to.
Wonderful idea! As long as your young charge here doesn't mind me tagging along.
Not at all, sir.
After you.
Ages since I've been to the castle. Would be good to see the old pile of rocks.
Just barely.
And who is your traveling companion?
A new student.
New?
Yes, sir. I'm starting school as a fifth year.
How extraordinary.
It is indeed. None of the faculty has ever heard of anyone being admitted to Hogwarts so late.
Nor have I.
Of course, as the other fifth years will have been honing their magical skills for 4 years now, the headmaster asked if I could get our new student up to speed a bit before the term begins.
Well, you couldn't have asked for a better mentor. Professor Fig is not only an exceptional teacher, he's also a remarkably intuitive and gifted wizard.
Mr. Osric is prone to flattery. I dare say it's one of the reasons he's risen so far at the ministry.
Have you seen this?
I have. Opinions differ as to how great a threat Ranrok really is.
Although I've yet to convince my colleagues at the Ministry, I believe he is a significant threat. And it was your wife, Eleazar, who alerted me to his activities months ago.
Miriam? How?
She wrote to me about Ranrok before she died, wondering what the Ministry knew about his activities. Before I could respond, I received this. It was the last thing she sent me, Eleazar. It came to me via her owl, but with no correspondence. I can only assume
that she had to get rid of it quickly to keep it safe.
Presumably from Ranrok. I cannot open it. Whatever magic protects this is powerful indeed.
It looks like goblin metal. That symbol.
What's that glow?
I don't see a glow.
Nor do I. Merlin's beard. How did you...
Wait. We do...
Hang on!
perhaps a bit.
Take this. It's Wiganworld potion. That stuff will right you in a second.
What happened?
Poor George. I can't believe he... What the hell got into that damn thing? Attacking a carriage mid-air? A typical dragon would never...
Professor? Sir, where are we?
I'm not sure. But that key you discovered was clearly a portkey.
Portkey?
An item enchanted to bring whoever touches it to a specific place.
I'm feeling better, sir, if you'd like to look around a bit.
I would. But stay close. We've no idea who created this portkey. Or why.
Those sounds are so realistic. I thought there was something being in my house. That's why I just...
Take us
farther from London than the carriage traveled. We're somewhere in the Scottish Highlands.
Sir, those ruins. Do you think
the portkey was meant to lead us there? I do. This has not been the day either of us expected. But Miriam sent that portkey to George for a reason. And I believe that she, and now George, died in pursuit of whatever it was meant to lead to. If you're sure you're all right, and wouldn't mind indulging me, I'd like to have a look around.
Absolutely, sir.
Good. Let's see if we can find a path, however faded it may be. Mind your step.
Where do you suppose your wife got the portkey that brought us here?
A good question. Miriam spent years searching for evidence of a long-forgotten form of ancient magic.
Ancient magic?
Yes. A powerful magic wielded by a rare few that seems to have been lost to time. Hogwarts Castle was built by, and is itself a stronghold of that ancient magic. I don't know where she came into possession of the portkey, but I am certain it was to do with that search. Ah, there's the path down below. This way!
But sir, why was your wife searching for evidence of lost magic?
Miriam wanted to understand why such powerful magic disappeared from the wizarding world. Spoke of the good it could do. But magic is no different than any power. What really matters is the one who wields it.
Is that ice?
It's not cold enough here. It appears to be a sort of enchantment. Someone wanted to block this path. Let's see some of that wand work you were practicing. Focus on the center. Was a bit rougher than I'd expected. Your wand works improving with every cast.
Thank you, sir.
Ah, up there. We're close now. It's just ahead. Steady yourself! Reparo!
here?
I suspect they valued their privacy. That porky led us here for a reason. Let's have a look around for anything that seems out of place.
Professor, this statue...
This may have been his home!
Professor, it's a mural of some kind.
Perhaps our host was a noted seer. Interesting.
Enchanted crystallized stone again. But what could it be blocking? What's this? Professor Fig!
How odd. Why would someone have conjured that enchanted stone here?
And how is there a room behind it?
What room? I don't see anything.
There's that glow again, like the glow on the portkey container.
What in Merlin's name? Godric's heart.
Where are we?
I don't believe it.
Hello?
Just a moment. Where are we here? Welcome to Gringotts Wizarding Bank. Vault number 12, I presume.
Precisely.
The key.
Your wife's portkey.
Oh, yes, of course. This way, then.
Stay close.
After you. Inside the cart, if you don't wish to lose them.
How many vaults are there?
Hundreds. In fact,
glow you saw on the porky container?
No, darker. I saw that same glow on the dragon's collar.
Yeah, what was that? We were just wondering about that goblin back there. He watches over the oldest section of the bank. Rare anyone goes there anymore.
When was the last time this vault was accessed?
A goblin has been stationed at my desk for hundreds of years. In that time, no one has visited Vault 12. Until today. Vault 12.
Thank you for your help.
What do you suppose we should be looking for?
I'm not sure. Sir, I wonder if you might...
The instructions for Vault 12 indicate that I am to grant access to the holder of the key and then close the door.
Wait.
Mr. Black?
Professor?
That was certainly unexpected. Let me think. There must be something here. Revelio, perhaps.
Revelio?
Yes, a revealing charm. No time like the present. Let's see what we're missing, shall we? Ready your wand and focus.
Revelio. There, I saw something.
Move a bit closer and try again.
A door.
Well, that's a start. There's that symbol again. I don't suppose you see a way to...
I do, Professor. That symbol has the same glow as the one I saw on the port key container.
If what you can see reveals the way forward, then I dare say we are about to discover the secret of this vault. Lead the way. Lumos! This is no ordinary vault. I suspect we will need to earn our way out of here.
What do you mean, earn our way out? Do you think this is some sort of test?
I do. But to what end, I can't say. Stay close. There will be no disapparating if things go poorly. Not out of Gringotts.
I see something up ahead.
What is it?
That glow again, but on the floor. When I moved towards the glow, it suddenly seemed as if the ground was swirling about.
Are you all right?
Yes, sir, I'm fine.
You seem to have caused the floor to change.
No,
that statue.
Shit.
What statue?
I see some sort of statue, but only as a reflection in the floor.
You're seeing.
Revelio.
I presume saw reflected in the floor.
It is. The reflection's still there, but the statue's positions don't match. Wait, when you moved, the reflection turned in the direction of the light.
Hmm. Perhaps you should cast Lumos.
Lumos.
Well done.
Now the reflection's turning towards me. It does follow the light.
I got nowhere to go.
Stay pumps!
I have no freaking choice.
Professor! Professor Fig! Professor, where are you? This isn't good. Where am I supposed to go? What's happening? The wisps of magic seem to be leading me somewhere. Where they're leading me, that glowing Lumos. Revelio. I suppose I'm on my own this time. Lumos. Align these statues with their reflections. Lumos.
Hello! Are you there?
Professor Fig!
Yes, Godric's heart, I'm glad you're all right. I'm somehow back in the entry room to the vault.
I don't see a way to open the door.
There must be something. I'll keep looking over here.
Lumos.
Not sure how much this will help, but time to try as well.
Revelio.
How did you... What is this place?
I don't know. But I found this floating above that basin.
That is no mere basin. That is a pensieve for viewing memories. I wonder... Follow my lead.
All is in place.
The portkey is well hidden.
Perhaps too well. I wonder if the path we've created
may be impossible to follow. It will only be impossible for one who cannot see traces of ancient magic as I can.
Your ability to see what others cannot will not be enough, Percival. We are entrusting the one who embarks on this path with powerful secrets, with knowledge others will do anything to obtain.
Yes, and if we are correct, Charles, the witch or wizard who completes the trials will have proven themselves worthy of that knowledge and the responsibility that accompanies it.
done all that we can.
That's what you're seeing. The glow that surrounded them.
Yes, sir.
Astonishing.
Can I see magic?
Traces of an ancient magic, to be precise. The magic that Miriam had always believed existed, but could never. Miriam, and perhaps George, died in pursuit of knowledge that has been dormant for centuries. And you, it seems, are the key to understanding why. We were.
It all looks rather different than it did a moment ago.
Someone's coming.
Who were they?
I don't know. But, sir, you shouldn't be in here.
I was right.
Ranrock.
Seems my reputation precedes me. I was beginning to think no one was ever going to visit Rackham's Vault.
And why are you here?
No need for that. Just give me whatever it is you found here and we can let bygones be bygones.
Sir, they have the key to the vault.
Choose your next words wisely.
I only meant that the instructions to Vault 12 were quite clear. Sir, I must insist. I was to grant access only to one with the key, and you didn't have them.
I have no patience for traitors. Now, where were we?
I'm not giving you anything.
Well, perhaps your young friend here will be more helpful.
Are you all right?
Fine, sir.
I've never seen so powerful a goblin. He seemed wholly unaffected by my magic.
Where are we?
It can't be. It seems those who set up the pensieve, the locket, and the path to both, wanted someone with your ability to end up here. Come. We have a sorting ceremony to get to.
sorting ceremony. I'm no expert, but that seems more appropriate. Now, I need to study this locket as soon as I can, but first I must contact the Ministry. They need to know what happened to George and be warned of Ranrock. For the moment, I ask that you keep all that's happened this evening between you and me.
Of course, sir.
Thank you. Ready for the sorting ceremony? Phineas Nigellus Black. Prepare yourself to meet the headmaster.
Fig, nice of you to join us. The sorting ceremony is over.
There were complications.
Complications?
It seems the goblin problem
has... Goblins. I've no time for rumors, Fig, and I'm rapidly losing whatever patience I had left. If you're lucky, we might still be able to get you sorted this evening.
I'll be in touch.
Well, JP, if you're there, hello.
Professor Weasley, we've one more to be sorted.
Welcome. You're just in time. Have a seat.
Ah, yes. A bit older than the others, aren't you? You come here with preferences and preconceptions. Certain expectations.
I'm looking forward to exploring Hogwarts and the world beyond the castle and grounds.
Indeed. Much can be gleaned by having an adventurous spirit, but your professors have a great deal to teach you as well. I wonder. I detect something in you. A certain sense of. What is it?
A desire to learn? I do enjoy a good puzzle, and I believe I have a ready mind.
You're clever indeed. You have the ability to reflect clearly on that which puzzles others. And you've a ready mind, quick to learn. Perhaps you belong in Ravenclaw.
Yeah, I figured.
You belong in Ravenclaw!
And one more thing. Due to the unfortunate injury on the pitch in last spring's final, this year's Quidditch season has been cancelled. Enough! It's not as though I've banned flying altogether. But don't tempt me. You are here to focus on your academic futures. I'm sure you will have plenty to do before classes begin tomorrow. I said, I'm sure you all have plenty to do before classes begin tomorrow.
You know, you can just say, you're dismissed.
Quite an entrance. It's lovely to meet you. I'm...
Professor Weasley, would you be so kind as to show our new student to their common room?
I shall see to it, sir. As I was saying, I'm Professor Weasley. Pleased to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well, Professor.
As Deputy Headmistress, it is my distinct honor to show you to your common room. Right this way. It's quite uncommon for a student to begin as a fifth year. Might be a bit of a challenge, but one I'm sure you're up for.
I am, Professor.
This is the entrance to the Ravenclaw Common Room. You must solve a riddle to enter. I won't be of much help, I'm afraid. This sort of thing has always confounded me.
Who lived longer? The ghost or the poltergeist?
A ghost or a poltergeist? A non-being can never have been.
I'm glad I didn't have to figure that out, because that would not have been.
Well done. Now, go on in and get some sleep. You have a big day ahead of you tomorrow. I shall be back in the morning to collect you for your first class.
Thank you, Professor Weasley.
You're welcome. I hope you enjoy your first night at Hogwarts. Sleep well.
Looks like everyone's gone. Better head to the common room. I suppose some introductions are in order.
Just have to wait for the right moment. One moment. Watch this. That wasn't quite the reaction I wanted. Oh well.
Right. What did you hope would happen?
I suppose I hoped it would lighten the mood. Ravenclaws can be a bit on edge the first day of class. I'm Everett, by the way. You seem downright calm next to some of these characters, and you survived a rather harrowing trip here.
Harrowing indeed. I'm still a bit on edge myself and a little nervous for classes to start.
Oh, you needn't be worried. Truly, there's no reason to be nervous. Most professors are firm but fair. I mean, not all of the tricks I play are as simple as a tossed dung bomb, and I'm still here.
Wait, did you say most professors are firm but fair?
Ha, I did. But probably best I let you judge for yourself. I do tend to push their limits. I should wander off before someone traces that dung bong back to me. Nice meeting you.
You too, Everett.
All right.
Deep breath. Why, hello. Would you like to take a look? Can't see too much in the day. Well, except for stars like Sirius, Canopus, Vega, and Arcturus. I'm Amit. Pleasure to have you in Ravenclaw. Never met someone who's been so close to a dragon before.
Can't say I'd recommend it, frankly. It's nice to meet you, Amit. I take it you like astronomy.
Oh, yes. So much to be learned from the stars. Also, there's something about the open air and night sky above the tower. It's invigorating. You will adore astronomy. Professor Shaw is incredibly knowledgeable.
I hope astronomy's on my schedule. Sounds interesting.
I have good news for you. You are most definitely taking astronomy. It is required for all fifth years. You will be enthralled with the tower. Plus, a quality telescope can show you things you never dreamed of.
I suppose I'll see you in class, then.
Yes. Oh, and speaking of class, better get to my first one of the year. Nothing like the smell of fresh parchment, is there? Be seeing you!
the right spot. I want him to be in the perfect place, a place he'll be happy with, but I can't seem to find it. Great golden gobstones! I want him to thrive here.
Golden gobstones?
My own little expression. I bought this Dittany seedling from home, and I so want him to feel cozy. Dittany is amazing, isn't it? So much healing power in such a little plant. I've a bit of a thing for plants, as you can see. Pleased to meet you.
Hey.
I'm Samantha.
Nice to meet you, Samantha. Is Dittany used in Wiganwell potion?
It is. Looks like someone's been studying up on their potion making.
Actually, Professor Fig told me about the Wiganwell potion.
Of course. I heard you were studying with him before term. He's an enigma, Fig. Teaches about theory, yet seems to know a lot about practical magic.
Professor Fig does know a great deal about, different forms of magic.
Well, I hope he told you about more than Wiganweld. You've lots to catch up on, I'm sure.
An affinity for herbology is more typical of a Hufflepuff than a Ravenclaw, isn't it?
Ordinarily, perhaps, but it runs in my family. We've a full plot of these little fellows back home. I suppose you could say herbology is in my roots.
Is it common practice for students to grow their own ingredients?
Oh, yes. In fact, our herbology teacher, Professor Garlick, encourages it.
Of course, the herbology.
And I don't think Professor Sharp, our potions master, cares where you get your ingredients, as long as your brews are all perfect.
It was nice to meet you, Samantha. Good luck with your Dittany.
Thank you. And good luck to you, too, on your first day.
Hey there, new Ravenclaw. Professor Weasley is looking for you just outside. You'd best not keep her waiting.
Good morning. I trust you're ready for your first day at Hogwarts.
I've been dreaming of this day for a long time. Can't believe I'm here.
Well, you are here. Make the most of it. You only have one first day at Hogwarts. Now, in light of your unique situation, joining us as a fifth year, you'll need to catch up with your classmates and not fall behind. Especially as you'll be expected to complete your OWLs at the end of the year.
OWLs? OWLs?
Yes, your ordinary wizarding level exams. They will determine what type of career you can have when you leave here. After much discussion with the headmaster and the Department of Magical Education at the Ministry, we've devised something extraordinary to ensure your success. Here you are.
What is it?
It is a wizard's field guide. It will help you to keep track of what you are learning so that you master all that's expected of a fifth year. You would be wise to take full advantage of this exceptionally valuable resource.
Thank you, Professor, but what do you mean it will keep track of what I'm learning?
Perhaps seeing it in action will answer any questions you may have. Walk with me and we shall put it to the test. This way. The guide will give you opportunities to practice your magic and educate yourself about wizarding lore. I certainly would have appreciated something like the field guide when I was a student. Why don't you cast Revelio on this bust and see what details the field guide can provide?
Revelio!
This bust, created in honor of Ravenclaw House, resides in the lofty Ravenclaw.
Keep your eyes open for more opportunities like that, inside and outside of the castle. No time to waste. You've classes to attend.
Well, if you weren't walking so slow, I could probably get to my classes on time.
Timing. Perfect opportunity to show you how to use blue flames to get around a bit quicker. Your field guide contains a map of the castle. Open it up and find Central Hall. And here we are, quite the time saver. These stairs lead directly to Central Hall. You can get almost anywhere in the castle quickly from Central Hall. Always something happening here. It's the heart of the hive, our King's Cross station, so to speak. That should be all for now. You'll be expected to attend both Charms and Defense Against the Dark Arts classes today. And I'd like to be sure you get to Hogsmeade as soon as possible to replace the supplies you lost on the way here.
Can you tell me more about the Defense Against the Dark Arts class?
Defense Against the Dark Arts, as the name implies, focuses on how to defend oneself against the evils that lurk beyond these walls. A mastery of defense against the dark arts is required for those who aspire to become aurors. Fortunately, we are lucky to have the ever-gifted Professor Hecate in charge of our students' education in that regard.
What will I learn in charms class?
Exactly what you might expect. Spells, charms, jinxes, all terribly useful. I think you will enjoy Professor Ronan. He's a clever and entertaining wizard. And a talented teacher.
You mentioned Hogsmeade, Professor.
Hogsmeade is the only all-wizarding village in Britain, and is home to an array of shops and pubs. You should be able to find all of the school supplies you require in Hogsmeade. You will also, I imagine, enjoy many a butterbeer there with friends in due course.
Thank you, Professor Weasley.
A lot to absorb on your first day. And you have much to learn. Happily, your professors have agreed to create additional assignments for you outside of class. You'll be up to speed in no time. Judging
Yay,
by your adept use of Revelio earlier, I'd say Professor Fig succeeded in at least showing you the basics.
He did, Professor.
He's been terribly vague as to the events preceding your arrival, specifically about what happened after that awful dragon attack. My suspicion is that there's more to the story than a search for belongings and an extended trip up to the castle.
I'm sorry, Professor, but I'm afraid that's all there is to it.
Almost precisely what Professor Fig said. Speak of the devil, Professor Fig. Your ears must have been burning.
Oh?
Yes. You seem to have provided our new fifth year with a solid foundation in the basics of spellcasting.
Ah, I'm afraid I can't take all the credit there, Professor. They've a rare aptitude for magic, it seems.
Well, I'm just glad you both arrived in one piece. Perfectly good boats and carriages to Hogwarts, and you chose to fly in the path of a dragon.
I wouldn't say I chose the dragon's path, Professor. Rather unfortunately, it would seem that it chose us.
Very well. Enough chit-chat. I need to get to class myself. Might I rely on you, Professor Fig, to explain the details of the field guide's map?
Of course.
Thank you. Good luck today. And remember to use your field guide. It will be invaluable to you. And invaluable to me, as I'll be using it to keep up to date on your progress.
Yes, Professor.
Come and find me in my classroom after you've attended both classes today, and I'll explain more about those assignments I mentioned. And we'll see if we can't get you to Hogsmeade for those supplies.
It's good to see you, Professor.
And you. I was hoping our paths would cross today, before you immersed yourself in studies. Did I hear you masterfully evade Professor Weasley's interrogation regarding our late arrival?
I did my best, but I'm fairly certain she suspects that we're not being entirely forthcoming.
Yes, well, Professor Weasley is a brilliant and astute witch. It was right to keep the details to yourself for now. We don't know where this path we've embarked upon will lead. It may require a bit more flexibility with your time than she would approve of. And she may feel obliged to share details with the headmaster that would be better left between us.
Understood, Professor.
Good. Now, as capable as you are, I believe the ability you possess obliges you to be well-trained. Happily, you have the benefit of an exceptionally skilled team of witches and wizards to guide you. Speaking of guides, and so that I may avoid another not-so-subtle reproof from Professor Weasley, why don't I show you the clever enchantment we included in the field guide's map? Unfold it and have a look. The map is enchanted to help you find your way.
This will be incredibly helpful. Thank you.
Now, sounds like you've quite a day ahead, what with classes and a trip to Hogsmeade for supplies, including your own wand. You'll enjoy Mr. Ollivander. He's an exceptional craftsman and a good friend. I shall reach out when I have more information about our mysterious locket. For now, focus on your classes and pay attention. More than your owls may hinge on the magic you are able to master within these walls.
You'd be good enough to blast each other to pieces on your own time. I get new students every year, but I only have one Hebridean black skull. It was a token from the great poacher raid of 1878. No doubt you've heard of it. Now, you may be asking yourself how an old woman like me single-handedly took out the largest poacher ring in eastern Wales and lived to boast about it. Knowledge. To the wise, age matters very little. Today we will review a spell that has saved me from death at the hands of dark wizards more times than I care to remember. Levioso.
Levioso? A levitation charm?
Levioso! A surprised opponent is a weak opponent. Care to defend yourself, Master Pruitt? No? One thing I've learned as an unspeakable is the value of simplicity, especially in the heat of battle. Now, let's practice what we've just learned, starting with something small.
Levioso!
Now, let's try something a little larger.
And you'd have to actually do the motion, like, oh god, that would be so fun. Slytherin boy almost fell.
Let us begin with a basic cast. See how the dummy deflected your cast? This time, cast Levioso first, then the basic cast. Remember, a surprise. Good. Now, the basic. Well done. Very good. But the best way to practice is by dueling. We'll start with you two. Duelist, take your marks.
Time for a proper Hogwarts welcome.
Now, I want a fair duel, using only Levioso, basic cast, and Protego. You may begin.
Levioso, Protego.
Lucky.
Nothing lucky about it. This can't be your first duel. Let's just say I'm a...
Don't all of my students do this again. I do, John. Try to anticipate your opponent's next move.
Not bad for a beginner. You give as good as you get.
You got destroyed, boyo. What do you mean, not bad?
I put you on the spot, and you rose to the challenge. Points to Ravenclaw.
Thank you, Professor Hecate. Glad to have the opportunity to practice.
If what I've seen today is any indication, we can expect great things from you. I demand excellence from my students. They are capable of achieving it, and they must achieve it. A classroom duel is one thing, but battling dark wizards, or as ever more likely, goblins, is a different kettle of Grindelows entirely.
Understood, Professor.
So, I'd advise you to keep practicing whenever you can. Perhaps Mr. Sallow will have some ideas for you. Again, well done today. I shall reach out soon with additional assignments.
Yay, more.
All right, that's enough spectacle for one day. Class is dismissed.
I'd hate to face Professor Hecate in a duel.
Nice work.
I enjoyed that.
Well, that duel was quite something. Everyone will be talking about it.
It was certainly good practice.
Practice? It felt more like I was dueling an expert. Sebastian Sallow, by the way.
Wow.
Didn't expect a new student to be so deft with a wand. Then again, perhaps this wasn't your first duel.
In fact, it was. Perhaps I have a knack for it.
Be coy if you like, but I know better. Magic requires intention and talent. You know, you might be a perfect fit for a certain exclusive, unsanctioned dueling organization.
There it is.
Exclusive and unsanctioned. Count me in.
Excellent. Knew I was right about you. If you want to get the most out of your time at Hogwarts, you're going to need to break the rules now and then. Whether it's joining a secret dueling club, or sneaking into the restricted section of the library, you just have to be clever enough not to get caught.
Thank you, Sebastian. I'll keep that in mind.
Good. Pleasure chatting with you. I'm sure I'll see you soon. Perhaps somewhere unsanctioned? We'll see if your performance today was sheer luck or actual skill. Look for Luke and Brattleby near the clock tower entrance, if you're interested. Till next time.
Huh. Always thought Leviosa was for first years. Not anymore.
Revelio.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
Levioso. Revelio.
For this stream, just so you guys know what to expect, you can follow the main quest.
My life is behind me. I promise.
Don't worry about side quests just yet.
Professor Ronan tends to go on a bit.
Werewolves, where were you? In the Goblin Rebellion of 1752.
And by the end of it, the Minister for Magic was Albert Boot.
No, it wasn't.
Oh, I won't say my goodbyes. I shall cheer for the boy who says you're telling lies.
I'm not telling lies, Peace. It was Albert Boot.
No, it wasn't. It was Basil Flack.
Ooh, fight, fight. It's a bold attack. Was the Minister a Boot or the Minister a Flack?
Stop it, Peeves, you'll get us in trouble.
In trouble you will be, but you can't give Peeves a swag. She says it's a boot, and he says it's a flat.
Peeves, enough. You'll get us all detention. Oh, and you're both wrong anyway. It was Hephaestus Gore.
It wasn't boot and it wasn't flack, but you're all in trouble with Professor Black.
Professor Black have children of his own?
My older brothers were also.
Here, behind you, there is an open seat here.
Thank you.
She reminds me of the girl from the Polar Express.
Hello, I am Nettie. So you are the new student. Have you met Professor Ronan yet?
Shall we begin? Welcome to year 5 of charms. Now, this will be a crucial year in your education on the art of charm work, but I am confident that we will take hold with the passion and rigor requisite of such a challenge. Right, now, everyone, please open your textbooks to page 517. But before we begin, can anyone here tell me the difference between the incantations of the color change and growth charms? Anyone? Anyone? Hmm? I am afraid it is too late to study now. the summer months must have really taken a toll on you all. By the looks of it, you all spent your holidays practicing Obliviate on one another. Do you even remember how to perform a basic summoning charm? Well, it seems that we are in dire need of review. Everyone get into pairs and take positions on opposite sides of the classroom. Now let's put those textbooks to use as the blunt objects you so believe they are, and take turns summoning them out of one another's hands. Only one book will be needed per partnership, Miss Dale. Thank you. Get into place now.
That is not bad.
You are a swift learner. I see a lot of potential, but remember, potential is nothing without practice. Keep at it. You might just rival Miss Onai here. Very good, everyone. That's enough of that. Well, as you all seem to have the basics down, and it is an exceptionally lovely day, I was thinking that we might have ourselves a little excursion outside for a spot of fresh air. After me!
He doesn't want to come near.
I've always found that fun goes hand in hand with mastery, as I'm sure the Quidditch players amongst us would agree, So, what better than a bit of sport to put our prowess with the summoning charm to the test, right? So why don't we have our newest student start us off? Simply cast Accio on one of the spheres and relinquish your charm at the last possible moment. Now, Accio, this is like gobstones, if you will. That's it! Very good! Stay focused! Excellent control! Not to worry. Very good! Points to Ravenclaw. Well, there's certainly no sport in playing without some friendly competition. Miss Onai, would you care to give our new student a bit of a challenge? Come on up. You'll be the blues, just as before, and Miss Onai, you are playing red. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Let us see this.
Let's make this a bit more interesting, shall we?
I think we are well past interesting at this point.
I'll say.
Enough chatter. Focus now. You will need it. This round settles it all.
Let us see this. That is how it's done.
Perfect score! Remarkable!
I'm getting good at this.
Very good, both of you. Well done.
Class is dismissed. Gather your things on the way out.
Good game back there. I must admit, I think I underestimated you. Took me weeks to become proficient with Akio. Took weeks for me to get anything right when I transferred here. It gets easier, I promise.
That's good to hear. It's a lot to take in all at once.
To put it lightly, I remember how I felt when I first arrived. I transferred here from Wagadu just before my fourth year. My mother received an offer to teach divination here. Before I knew it, we had left Uganda and were halfway around the world at a new school in a new country.
Is Wagadu much bigger than Hogwarts?
Wagadu School of Magic is the largest wizarding school in the world. So yes, bigger than Hogwarts. But it never seemed intimidating or overwhelming to me. It always felt like home.
Is Wagadu a castle, like Hogwarts?
Its address is Mountains of the Moon. It is not so much a castle as a beautiful edifice carved out of the mountainside. I remember the first time I saw it, the mist was so thick I could hardly make out anything at all. And then it just materialized before me, this enormous school that seemed to be floating in midair.
This may seem an odd question, but is magic the same there as it is here?
Mostly, yes. But I did have to learn how to use a wand when I arrived here. Hardly anyone at Wagadu uses one.
You can cast spells without a wand.
Oh, yes. I find wandless magic to be much more instinctive. Not to mention quite convenient if one is without their wand. I must admit, however, that I am growing quite fond of using a wand. It seems very dramatic.
It's nice to learn about another wizarding school.
Thank you for asking. I do miss Wagadu, but I am glad to be here at Hogwarts. Ah, I think Professor Ronan wants to talk to you. Better not keep him waiting. Until next time.
Of course, you can use
a word, if you would.
You wanted to speak with me, Professor?
I did. I trust your first charms lesson lived up to expectation?
Well, an outdoor competition wasn't exactly the lesson I was expecting, sir.
What charm is there in the expected? You did well, managing to best as gifted a student as Miss Onai.
Thank you, Professor. I enjoyed the match.
Miss Onai is always a fierce competitor, though I sense that she is a bit distracted of late. Now, Professor Weasley has asked that your professors give you instruction outside of the ordinary curriculum. Expect to hear from me soon regarding a special assignment that I am preparing for you.
Hello. How was your first day coming along?
Hello, Samantha. Nice to see you again.
I wondered how your first day was going. You certainly seem to hold your own in charms.
I've been fortunate. Beginner's luck.
My brother William would tell you not to be so humble and to trust your abilities. Then again, he tends to be overconfident in his. Well, better see to my charms homework. I'm afraid I can't count on beginner's luck to impress Professor Ronan. What are you up to now?
Fuck, said that. Her?
Don't get too cocky simply because you had one victory over Sallow. He never backs down from a fight.
It's fine. Bathrooms.
Revelio. Rebellion. Revelio. Lumos. Revelio.
Handy resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased.
Revelio. Revelio.
Then it's not on your nose. Thought you'd want to know. Not sure he's in at the present moment, the headmaster. We'll be sure to tell him how very much you despise.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
Revelio. Lumos.
What about the room, Professor?
I was thinking the same thing, Deke. Perhaps you could help.
Oh, excuse, Deke.
Ah, there you are. I trust your first classes went well?
They did, Professor.
I heard as much from Professors Hecate and Ronan. Seems Professor Fig taught you quite a bit before you arrived. I'd wager there's a good deal more to your travels here than what you've told me, isn't there?
Nothing more, Professor.
I see. Like trying to get a sonnet from a streamer. Regardless, you must continue to build upon what you've learned. In that regard, I've asked your professors to help hasten your progress with some extra assignments.
Professor Ronan did mention something about that.
In fact, Professor Ronan will meet you outside momentarily to assign your first one. Now, regarding the trip to Hogsmeade I mentioned earlier, We've arranged to replace the supplies lost on your way here, including seeds, potion recipes, and spellcrafts.
Thank you, Professor.
And Mr. Ollivander will connect you with the perfect wand. You've managed your classes well with a borrowed wand, but you'll find the magic you cast with your own wand to be far superior.
There's an Ollivander's in Hogsmeade.
There is. Most people are familiar with the shop in Diagon Alley. We're fortunate to have someone like him nearby. Mr. Ollivander is a genuine craftsman and highly skilled wand maker. I would trust no one else to pair me with a wand.
I've never heard of a spellcraft before, Professor. What is it?
A spellcraft is a recipe of sorts used when conjuring objects. I shall explain more about them when you begin working with transfiguration magic.
Can you tell me more about the potions shop, Professor?
J. Pippin's Potions stocks a wide array of potions ingredients, although they rarely sell recipes. Professor Sharp asked that they have a couple of particular recipes on hand for you.
I'm eager to get to Hogsmeade.
Very well. I'd like you to make your first visit to the village with a classmate. Help you get your bearings. Perhaps Sebastian Sallow or Natsai Oni. I've noticed you spending time with them.
I'd like to go with Natty.
Excellent choice. Miss Oni is one of our most talented students. And she knows the area. She'll keep you well clear of any of Victor Rookwood's undesirables en route.
Rookwood?
A rather unsavory local. Best to avoid him and his associates, including his right hand of sorts, Theophilus Harlow, if you can. Once you've finished Professor Ronan's assignment, your friend will meet you at the castle doors. No time to waste. The sooner you complete your work, the sooner you can enjoy a butterbeer at the Three Broomsticks.
When completed, reward you with your spells.
The reward for completing your first assignment will be the mending charm or repair, which is required to complete other quests. You can track assignments and quest progress in the quest menu of your field. Another kitty cat. Hello. I wish I could really pet you. My dog ran away, so. Not ran away. He went upstairs.
Ah, there you are.
You have a new spell to teach me, Professor.
Indeed I do, and an exceedingly useful one at that, the mending charm, Reparo. Fixes things right up, makes a broken object good as new in the blink of an eye.
It seems as if that might come in handy.
More frequently than one would imagine. As Professor Weasley mentioned, I am not the only one who will be teaching you spells outside of class in an effort to catch you up with your peers. A number of your professors have agreed to do so as well, but first, each shall ask that you complete a few preliminary tasks to hone your magic. I have arranged some for today. See them through and then report back to me. We will have you casting Reparo in no time.
Why must I first complete tasks to learn Reparo?
No lesson or lecture can compare to first-hand experience. And these tasks should provide you with just that. Such experience is invaluable when mastering any new bit of magic.
I'll start on the task right away, Professor. This is the right area. I wonder where the flying page is. Got it. A flying page must be around here somewhere.
If only a new student would help me in that predicament.
Brilliant.
Some kind soul help me.
Are you all right?
Don't you know who I am?
Zenobia Noak, the girl whom everyone at school hates for no reason.
Everyone hates you? Why?
Because Hogwarts is full of bullies and spoilsports. Leander Pruitt's one of the worst, that no-talent moon mind. I wanted to make some new friends, and so I brought my collection down to the common room. My gobstone collection, that is. I was hoping someone would want to play. Are you familiar with gobstones? Little balls, like marbles. Grand game. And if you lose, they spray you with a foul-smelling liquid.
Gobstones? Sounds like a fun challenge.
That's what I tried to tell everyone. People can be so cruel. Just because they're sprayed all over with smelly gobstone spit, it's their own fault for losing. Imelda is one of the worst losers. Everett and Astoria are terrible as well. And now those poor losers have taken my gobstones and hidden them in very high places all over the school.
Rather an overreaction on their part.
I'll say. Anyway, I can't work out how to get them back on my own. I don't think I know the necessary spells yet. I need someone, perhaps a selfless and talented fifth year, to help me.
I'll see what I can do.
I'd appreciate the help. If you do find all of my gobstones, do come and see me again. I'll be back to playing Snake Pit and Jackstone by myself in no time.
I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones.
Accio!
Well, that's one of Zenobia's gobstones. I hardly see what all the fuss is about.
Remember when I said I was gonna stick to main quests?
Yeah, me too. Never thought I'd witness Sebastian.
Better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones. Revelio.
You can't imagine
how. I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones.
Revelio.
I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones. Accio! I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones.
Off on another adventure, are we?
Revelio.
This room contains the House Cup, Quidditch trophies, dueling trophies, and other awards given at the school. The students who step out of line can be found polishing the silver here by hand as a reminder of the hard work.
Revelio.
Goblin fire rests within the sage and jewel encrusted chest. The goblin has served as a means of selecting champions for the Triwizard tournament since the establishment.
How nice to see you, my young friend.
That's the last of Zenobia's gobstones. I should go and see her.
You've had more luck than I did tracking down my...
Hello, Zenobia. I found all your gobstones.
Really? I didn't think it was possible. However did you do it?
Common sense and basic magic.
Well, may I have my gobstones back?
Of course. They are yours, after all.
Oh, how wonderful. I shall dedicate all my future victories to you. Speaking of which... Now that I have all my gobstones back, I wonder if anyone in the common room would be up for a game.
I'm sure they'd be willing to play after the trouble spent getting them back. It's a fine idea.
Isn't it? Oh, we'll have so much fun together laughing as all the losers get sprayed, which won't include me. Very well, off I go. Wish me luck.
Thank you.
I trust the preliminary tasks weren't too much trouble.
Found in the Transfiguration courtyard has a likeness of a wyvern on top and serves as a relaxing place for students to gather, despite rumors to the contrary, possibly started by Sir Cadogan. This is most assuredly not meant to be the Wyvern of Wye, slain by the lively knight in Spider-Man.
I completed the assignments, Professor.
Marvelous. You clearly know your way around basic charms. Let us give the old mending charm a try then, shall we? Remember to be deliberate in your enunciation and movements. I want to see some vigor. Now, wand at the ready.
Yes, sir.
Remember, your wand is a conduit of your magic. That's it. Very good. If you would like to practice mending something, have a go with that broken statue in the alcove by the water. It allegedly symbolized heartbreak. Perhaps a jilted lover too accurate and lashed out.
Repairer.
Something quite satisfying about using the mending charm, isn't there?
Repairer.
Oh.
Repair.
All right, stream. I think I'm going to call it a night here.